everybody. My name is Dawn Perez, and I'm one of the education specialists at the Solid Waste Authority of Palm Beach County.
Hi, good morning. I'm Linda Moreno, volunteer coordinator at the Solid Waste Authority and Community Services.
And I'm Jennifer O'Brien, executive director at Resource Depot.
And I'm Chelsea Odom, the director of education and artist relations.
Thank you for joining us today for this recording. We're bringing you back some of those commonly asked questions from our residents today. We're going to focus on what kind of programs our two organizations offer, as well as how to get involved. So if you haven't already, be sure to check out our first three videos in this series on the SWA and Resource Depot Facebook pages. And if you have questions, please type them in the comments below. And don't forget to like and share this video and let us know in the comments where you're viewing from. So let's get started.
So what kind of programs does Solid Waste Authority offer?
Well, we have a variety of programs that we offer to all sorts of people that are curious about finding out what happens to their garbage and recycling. So we actually give tours to the community, as well as schools and VIP groups of our renewable energy facilities, our recovered materials processing facility, as well as our Greenway Trail system. We also do presentations for groups like HOAs and professional organizations. We do in-school programs where we actually do hands-on activities with the students that are based on the Florida State standards. And then you'll often see the education team and the public affairs and recycling team out and about at community events discussing recycling and signing people up for recycling bins. And of course, our lovely volunteers help with that as well. Keep in mind, all of our tours and our programs are free. And right now with the COVID-19 situation, we've also expanded our virtual programs. So previously we were offering virtual programs for before field trips when students would come to visit us. And now we're offering them for the public through our social media pages. And we're giving people an opportunity to go behind the scenes virtually at our facilities, which is pretty neat.
You mentioned your Greenway Trail system, which is really cool. I think that's a hidden gem that a lot of people don't know exists and that anybody can come during daylight hours, right, to come and walk the trails and things, especially now when everybody's just trying to get outside of their house. So we're definitely going to come check it out, my family and I. But the time that I most enjoyed is when we do our 5K run that Solid Waste Authority is so graciously a host of. So Resource Depot has a 5K run each spring where you get to run the trails, and it's kind of exciting. We've heard people have seen a lot of wildlife during their run, and all of the proceeds benefit Resource Depot. This year we had to do a virtual run, of course, but I encourage you to check back with us next spring because we're hoping that we'll be able to have a live run again, and it's a great thing to do. But meanwhile, check out the trails there. They're definitely, they're worth seeing.
Yeah, they're beautiful, and we actually have a trail camera program. We've caught bobcats, coyotes, alligators, all sorts of animals on there. So like Jen was saying, definitely check out our Runaway 5K, which happens in the spring. And of course, all the proceeds go to Resource Depot. And you'll also get an opportunity to tour our renewable energy facility too. So that's one of our yearly events. We also have an event in November called America Recycles Day. And so we also invite the community out to that event so that they can tour our facilities, they can interact with local green organizations and businesses, and they can see some of our heavy equipment up close and personal, which is fun. And of course, we have our coloring contest. So we announce the winners of our America Recycles Day coloring contest that day, which last year we had over 300 entries and some really good prizes. So that was pretty awesome. Sorry, go ahead.
I was gonna say, we're doing a lot of virtual programs as well. Always seem to be having events and things to do and ways that you can come join us at Resource Depot. And I'm gonna turn it over to Chelsea to tell you a little bit more about that because that's her domain.
If you haven't done a tour at Solid Waste Authority, I highly recommend it. It's very eye-opening. I think everyone in our county should go and check it out. In terms of our programs, we also offer tours, and our facility is much smaller. It's creative reuse, so we have a bunch of materials. We also have a gallery space that people can look at that houses local artists. So we have 4 to 5 shows there that the public can come and see. And then we, I currently have a virtual tour that I've been offering for people that do field trips with me. So we also do our field trip program with the schools and other organizations. And I've done 2 virtual field trips so far. So that's also an option currently and normally. We also have an after-school program that we participate in. We serve over 80 different sites throughout the school year.
Oh, wow.
And we're still doing that virtually as well. And we too go to events. So you'll see us out in the community at different events talking about ways that people can reuse. And we're happy to come to different organizations and give presentations on creative reuse as well. We also offer weekend workshops that we do with the community on different subject matters. We also have Catwalk, or reusable fashion, that we do once a year. We just did that and it ended up being a virtual event. It was a lot of fun. So look out for that next year. And yeah, and we, you know, obviously summer is here. So we do summer camps. Normally we have 3 weeks of summer camp, and we just started a middle and high school program called Maker Intensives. Currently all of that is going virtual. So we have Junk Hour, which is 1 hour every week for different grade levels that we'll be doing. And then we'll have 2 virtual Maker Intensives. And then we also have 55 days of summer, which is an activity every weekday during the summer for 55 days. So you can pick up a box of stuff and do an activity every day.
Oh, cool. Now, before we kind of go into more detail, I have a quick question, because I saw a while ago on your Facebook page that you had a workshop about using power tools. And I am not comfortable with using power tools. So I know that it's a little bit different with the situation you are in right now, or we're all in right now, but do you guys think you'll be offering that in the future again?
We would like to, yes. We just moved into a new space. So we're still trying to figure out how our new space works with some of our workshops. Okay. But we definitely would like to offer that workshop again. People really liked it. So
okay. Yes. Keep me in mind. Keep me in mind.
You'll be the first person I call.
Thank you.
So what other kind of summer programs do you guys offer?
Well, we typically have 2-week-long programs that we do in the summer. One of them is a program for middle school students, where they get behind-the-scenes tours of our facilities. They get their own hard hat and safety glasses and protection that they can take home afterwards, which is pretty cool. And we take them to a lot of our partners that we collaborate with. For instance, they go on field trips to Resource Depot. They go to the Loxahatchee Wastewater Treatment Center, as well as Grassy Waters. And it's just really neat. They really get to delve into garbage and recycling and see what happens when their waste goes away, because we like to call ourselves away. And then they really understand more the importance of reducing that waste. Of course, this year it's going to be a little bit different. Instead of having camp, we're going to be posting activities and videos for students on our website so that they can do things at home. So that's one of our programs. The other program we have is our teacher or educator program, and that's called the Reteach Waste program. And we'll be converting that into a virtual program this summer. So teachers will have the opportunity to log in online, go behind the scenes of different facilities virtually. We'll also be offering environmental education curriculum through Project Learning Tree, as well as Project Wild. And these programs are really great because they give teachers the tools to incorporate nature and environmental topics and municipal solid waste topics and things like that into classroom lessons in fun and engaging ways. So if anybody is interested in joining us in the future for our 3R Ambassador program, which is our middle school program, you can check out our website at swa.org/3R. And if you're interested in that virtual teacher program, which is going to happen in July this year, That would be swa.org/reteach.
I think it's great, even though, you know, we had to scramble a bit to get a lot of virtual, you know, basically make our programs virtual because we couldn't have any visitors. And of course, we're anxious to have visitors back. Right. I think it's great that it really provides another opportunity for people to see what we do, because we're putting a lot more content out there, I know, because we're trying to tell our story. So I think it's great. Again, some of the videos of the behind the scenes and what happens with your trash, I think it's, I always tell people it really is, it's lifestyle altering, because when you see really the amount that comes through your facility every hour, every day, it's a little depressing, but that's kind of where Resource Depot comes in as well, is like, we really want people to change their habits a bit. And when somebody gets involved with what we do at Resource Depot, it's really about reducing that waste and finding the best possible use and multiple uses for it before it has to get into your hands for you to deal with it.
Right.
But also, you know, we talk a lot about being a conscious consumer, mm-hmm. and really thinking about the longevity of something that you're buying. Is it going to be a one-time single use? I'm just going to grab this water bottle. I forgot mine at home. And then what happens to that versus something that, you know, like, for example, I just had to buy a new vacuum. And so I was really looking at a good quality, maybe not necessarily the cheapest vacuum, because I knew I wanted it to last a while. I didn't want it to break in a couple years and not be able to be fixed. And then I'm contributing to the problem. So it's not so much that you don't need to buy, it's that you're buying smart and you're buying for with the planet in mind. And so a lot of what we do at Resource Depot is really getting people to think again about the materials in their lives and other uses for them, and thinking creatively. So that's really how I feel, you know, people can get involved with us. And of course, all these programs that you mentioned, you know, getting online and checking out some of our great videos and content, we have it for all different ages. And certainly our complement each other. So I would encourage you to look at both of ours, because we tell a full story collectively, I think, between Solid Waste Authority and Resource Depot. And share the content too, if you find something interesting. We always want more people to know about what we do. And so just the simple act of forwarding it along or sharing it is really helpful. Of course, we still want people to be involved with us and not forget about us. We've opened up for donations by appointment. We're soon getting ready to open shopping by appointment. Partly just because we need to control, we like Chelsea mentioned, we're kind of a smaller facility and we're an unusual retail establishment. So we're different than a Publix or a, you know, a Target, where you can kind of walk in, and we're a smaller staff right now. So we ask for your patience, but check out our website and our social media channels. That's where we're putting the up-to-date information. We're really anxious to get people back through. We have a great video on how to donate, so if you ever have any questions about that, and it'll give you an idea too about the kind of materials you could expect to find if you come and shop with us in the materials marketplace in our treasury. And of course, we really need volunteers. I'm sure Linda will mention some about the volunteers too, but we really do rely on the generosity of others, not only in their donations and materials and money, but of their time and talents. And so if you have an interest in, if you're a crafter and you like making things, you can make some samples for us or write some lesson plans for us. If you are really into, you're kind of OCD and you like to sort and organize, we love you. You need to come to us. It's really a challenge to kind of organize everything. In fact, we ask people to kind of do, you know, if they could volunteer while they donate. They can do some of that sorting, pre-sorting before they even donate, and you're saving us a lot of time, surprisingly enough. So there's a lot of ways that we'd like you to get involved. Probably the best way is to go to our website and check us out, resourcedepot.org. Poke around a bit and kind of see what we're all about. And if something really connects to you, you know, reach out. We have a separate volunteer tab, but you could always reach out to any one of our staff members, even myself, and we'll get you connected to the right thing. So I know that, Linda, you're the one that maybe people should contact if they want to get involved with what you do.
Absolutely. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about how you can make an impact on the environment and the community by volunteering with the Solid Waste Authority. We have some great outreach programs, our special events, Green Team volunteers that participate in the 5K run. The run could not go on without our volunteers. They are just incredible. getting out there on the trails, cheering everyone on. It's really, really exciting. We have so much fun. We look forward to that event every year, as well as we participate at the South Florida Fair in January. That's 17 days. We have an amazing booth out there. We answer questions, helping our residents with any questions they may have about recycling, how to get new or replacement recycle bins. We also have staff out there every day, so it's fun to come and meet the staff and just answer all kinds of fun questions about our renewable energy facility, our trails. We also participate in many events throughout the year in the community. However, at this time, due to the COVID, those events are on hold right now. So some other things that we can do at the Solid Waste Authority by volunteering is we want to get volunteers involved virtually. So come and check out our education pages. You can take some lessons online. Get involved at home, like Jen said. You can make impact by doing just recycling right at home, educating your friends and families and neighbors on how to, you know, reduce your use. Use reusable things. Don't just, you know, do one time, throw stuff away. We really want you to make an impact. We want you to get out. And by you educating Palm Beach County residents on how to recycle right and source reduction and so forth, that's how you can get involved with the Solid Waste Authority. We have some great community service programs where we have volunteers actually come out and do beautification projects for the elderly, disabled, veterans. At this time, again, those are on hold, but when things get back up and running, we're excited to get everyone on board again. Pretty much every Saturday, we have those events going on. We also have a recycled paint program where residents can get a one-time donation of exterior recycled paint if you qualify. And you can go to our website at swa.org and look under recycled paint. Again, look under the volunteer page, our education page. We also have volunteers working in the office, and they help with data entry, filing, that kind of stuff. So we'll get that up and running once things are moving forward. and trying to think of any other events that we have going on, Dawn?
Well, I mean, typically in a usual year, we're at the Delroy Affair. You know, we're at a lot of community events. One thing I was going to mention is, Linda, I think I've been seeing some of your really awesome volunteers on Facebook with litter hikers. They Yes. just go out themselves and pick up the litter, and they have pictures and masks and stuff. And I've been loving to see them. Is that a way that maybe people can get involved virtually, where they kind of do their own cleanups and take pictures and send them to you or something?
That is a great question, Dawn. Absolutely. We have our Adopt-A-Spot program, mm-hmm. Which is great for any age and small groups. You can go out into the community and pick up litter. We give you the supplies to clean up. And yes, we have a really exciting group called the Litter Hikers. They're out in Boynton Beach every single day, every morning. If you're going out for a walk, and what else to do while you're walking? Take some gloves and a little picker and pick up litter while you're on your walk, getting some exercise. So go to our website. The program's called Adopt-A-Spot. We would love to have you join. We also clean up beaches. We partner with Keep Palm Beach County Beautiful. We have some great partnerships, again, with Resource Depot. We love to share our volunteers. We encourage everyone to volunteer. By volunteering, it gives you an opportunity to make new friends, learn new skills. It's just, you know, it's a win-win situation. So get out there, make an impact, and volunteer with SWA and Resource Depot.
Yes, please do. We love our community partners. Thank you so much, Resource Depot, for being involved in this four-part talk about trash and reducing and reusing. I wanted to say thank you to all of you for joining us today. Remember, if you have any questions, you can always type them in the chat box below, or you can email our organizations at education@swa.org, or for Resource Depot, it would be education@resourcedepot.org. Be sure to check out our other videos for answers to your most common recycling questions. And thank you again for tuning in today. Have a great day. Bye, guys.